I would say the fundamental difference between the United National Party and the Samagi Janabala Vegiya is democracy. Gotabaya Rajapaksa is now trapped. He is trapped because he has to work with the same horu, the crooks, the same bunch of politicians. Best thing right now, especially if you're looking at it, the way forward, is have a president from one party, have a prime minister and a government from another party.
But that's what happened in 2015.
2015, that was not the deal. Short answer is, I would like to see a Sri Lanka that will develop in our own pace, and a Sri Lanka where the youth of this country can say, this is home, this is our country. So that's the country that I would love to see.
Welcome everyone to another episode of Conversations. The late Gamit Dissanayake played a pivotal role in Sri Lankan politics. Today, I will be in conversation with son of the late Gamit Dissanayake and former MP Mayantha Dissanayake. Now, Mayantha is someone who is known by many to embrace empathy and kindness as his core values. Thank you so much for having this conversation.
Thank you so much for having me. It's really an honor to be here.
So, to start things off, you know, the elections are around the corner, and many people are increasingly becoming aware of the importance of voting based on party policies. So in that sense, how is the SJB, the Samagi Janabala Vegiya, different from the UNP?
Well, if you're talking about core values, principles, and what we want to achieve, very, very similar, because the majority of the Samagi Janabala Vegiya party is from the United National Party.
Mm-hmm.
So what, where we have grown up and how we have grown up does not change. What we want to do does not necessarily change. However, I would say the fundamental difference between the United National Party and the Samagi Janabala Vegiya is democracy. Internal party democracy. We talk about democracy and democratic values in the UMP. However, internally, you have a leader that is chosen for life without any, and if there is any changes that you want to do internally in the party structure, that is not possible. Whereas in the Samagi Janabala Vegiya, we believe that we will be able to have a structure that is democratic, where every member of the party, their voice can be heard internally and externally, and decisions will be made on a more democratic basis. There will be a consensus, there will be a compromise, whereas sometimes in the United National Party, when it comes to very sticky issues, it's generally the my way or the highway. So unfortunately, it has become in that way. And also in the Samagi Janabala Vegiya, we want to rally around a leader that can win. Politics is about obtaining power and getting into power so you can do things that you want to do and make the necessary changes that you want to change and do the development that you promise the people that you want to do. So sitting in opposition for many, many years and just withering away in opposition is not the answer for being in politics. So many of us thought that there will be an alliance created and the United National Party will be very much part and parcel of it. We do not know politics outside the United National Party. So it was very unfortunate when a very, very tough and somewhat painful decision was made that, the Samagi Janabala Vegiya to be formed. But saying that, I must reiterate what we've been saying right throughout the media, that the Samagi Janabala Vegiya was brought into existence with the concurrence and the approval of the working committee of the United National Party.
Like you said, many wished for a change in leadership of the party, and that led to the Samagi Janabala Vegiya being formed. What change do you think people really wanted?
People wanted someone who can win. Someone who does not necessarily promise things before an election.
Mm-hmm.
But after elections, if you're successful in that, in our attempt to win power and we come into power, fulfills those pledges. So the changes that people wanted was from the leadership of the party. They did not want a scenario where we have these musical chairs, where the chairs are, someone here sits somewhere there, and then someone there sits somewhere else. People wanted young leadership within the party. And fortunately, unfortunately, the United National Party at the last elections in 2015, if you look at the district results, elected young, capable, dynamic, honest politicians, members of parliament. So the United National Party in that sense was blessed in having a dynamic team, a young team. But unfortunately, the party leadership did not use that young team. We were all backbenchers, wasting our time in somewhat where we could have been utilized, we could have been used to really do work for the people. But unfortunately, the party leadership decided to go for a coalition government where we could have formed the majority and formed a government on our own. And unfortunately, again, the result of that was shown in 2018 with the 52 days. Maithripala Sirisena completely betrayed the pledge that the platform that he was elected on, betrayed it, and asked Mahinda Rajapaksa to become the Prime Minister and sworn him in as the Prime Minister. Again, unconstitutional, and we went to court against, and the Supreme Court gave a judgment on it. So I think it's a general feeling of being let down. The party members, from the members of parliament to the provincial councils to the Pradesh Sabha, the Nagar Sabha members, to the card-carrying rank and file of the UMP, felt somewhat let down and betrayed. So they wanted a change in the structure. They wanted the party to be more democratic. In fact, there was immediately after 2018 Palat Sabha, Pradesh Sabha, the urban council, municipal council elections, there was a Ruwan Vijayawardena committee that was formed to look into the necessary changes of the party. But again, unfortunately, there was a report. The committee sat. There was a report produced. Unfortunately, nothing in that report was implemented. I mean, earlier also there was a Pandiratna report, going back many years. The late chairman of the party, Mr. Pandiratna, was again tasked of revamping the party. Again, report was made, committee recommendations, wasn't followed through. So unfortunately, we keep going through this cycle. And this time around, many other leaders in the party, including senior vice presidents of the party, senior members of the party, senior members of parliament, senior members of the cabinet, felt that we can't simply go on like this.
And you did say that people felt let down. The former UNP-led government, which came into power in 2015, they were voted in by the public based on the promises they made, such as seeking justice for victims such as Lasantha Wickremathunga and Wasim Tajuddin. And then these didn't really seem to happen. And people lost faith in politicians, people lost faith in the party as a whole. Do you think things would be different if the Samagi Janabala Vegia comes into power? Do you think they would be more accountable?
Yes, that's why we are here with the Samagi Janabala Vegia. We want to hold our leaders in the party, and the structure of the party is made in such a way that we can hold our leaders accountable. And I know, and my belief is, Honorable Sajit Premadasa is in his core values, he's a Democrat, meaning a democratic person. So we expect him to not make the mistakes of the past. In fact, learn from the mistakes of the past. Learn from his father. Learn from the things that took place in the UMP before. Learn from what has happened recently. And deliver on the promises that are made. And we would ensure that the Samagi Janabala Vegia, our manifesto will be out in a couple of weeks, that we will hold our leaders accountable. We will hold our leaders accountable. Whereas in the UMP, we couldn't do that. Even being members of parliament, even at the parliamentary group, one would get up and say, Honorable Prime Minister, leader, these are things that we need to do. Sometimes the leader is in a good mood, he'll say, all right, but it never gets done. Very unfortunate. Sometimes the leader is not so patient and not so kind, and the member of parliament or the senior member has to just sit down. It's a very, very unfortunate scenario which took place in the UMP.
And that is not ideal if you're a leader.
That is not ideal if you're a leader, and that's not ideal if you want to come back into power.
And it's very important that the rule of law prevails in any country. But in Sri Lanka with the bond scam, it seems that some appear to be above the law. What are your views on this?
Well, again, it's a very, very unfortunate scenario. Even on the earlier question of Lasantha Vikramathunga and many others who actually suffered and gave their lives for the cause.
Mm-hmm.
Unfortunately, different side deals are made. They entertain people from the opposition. They entertain their views as well. And unfortunately, I mean, we promised that, we said all the huru, all the crooks, all the guys who were corrupt, all the dirty politicians will be taken to task. That's one of the principles and of Yahapalane, or good governance. But we didn't do that. We had 4.5 years and people turn around and tell us, where are the crooks that you said? They're not in jail. Where are the deal makers that you said you will not? Where is the justice? Where is the justice for Lasantha and so many others? Where is the justice? So people do question us, and when they question us, we have really no proper answer to give. The UMP has also expected a certain number of, you know, those who work for the party that will be looked after. The youth expected so many jobs and opportunities. We promised 1 million jobs. That didn't happen. We made empty claims that we have given 425,000 people jobs in that so many number of years. But the data does not support it. We have not created jobs. Mm-hmm. We did not as a government. Of course, you must give the credit where it's due. We did a lot of development work. If you go to certain districts and electorates, a lot of the roads were done, irrigation systems were done. So there was a lot of infrastructure development, and development work in general was done. Urban development was well done. So there was a lot of work done as well. But unfortunately, again, there was no marketing of that development work that was taking place. People did not know. We would go and do the road that is required. but we did not get the people of the area involved, and we did not market it. Now, for example, the previous governments, if some little road down, you know, is done, massive amounts of publicity is given. The president himself will come, or the prime minister will come and open that road. We really didn't do it in that way. It was more low-key. I do not know why, what the thinking was.
Probably the party didn't have a proper marketing strategy.
Possibly. And well, the government should have had it as well. But a lot of development work was done. Country, where the money was needed, it was spent.
Mm-hmm.
But unfortunately, we did not get the result of it, because it's our own fault. Our leaders did not, or the ministers did not market it.
It was interesting to note, a few days ago, leader of your party and the former opposition leader, Sajith Premadasa, stated that if the Samaghi Janabala Vege wins the elections, he is prepared to work with the president. How would this work? Because this would mean having to work with a completely different set of policies.
Very good question. I think at this moment in time, we'll be doing Gotabaya Rajapaksa a favor. The people of this country will be doing Gotabaya Rajapaksa and themselves a favor by giving the opposition the right to form the government. If the Samaghi Janabala Vege is given a proper mandate that we can form a government, Gotabaya Rajapaksa is now trapped. He is trapped because he has to work with the same Horu, the crooks, the same bunch of politicians that he promised to change. So if the people of this country think about it and they vote for the Pohutua party, if they vote for them and give them a majority in parliament, I don't know how effective, especially after the 19th Amendment, that Gotabaya as a president, as the executive president, as head of state, how he will be. What can he, what are the changes that he can make? Because he has to work with the same bunch of guys that he himself knows that is very, very difficult for him to work. So whereas if the people of this country gives a majority in parliament to the Samagi Janabala Vege, we have a fresh, clean set of politicians, members of parliament who will be elected. They will be able to, there will be a difference in terms of some of the policies, but that they'll have to work it out. But again, everything, Gotabaya is not a politician from the extreme left wing.
Mm-hmm.
He's also a center-right politician. His policies are center-right. So we are also center-right. So we'll have to establish a working relationship. But I think the best thing for this country, best thing right now, especially if you're looking at it the way forward, is have a president from one party, have a prime minister and a government from another party.
Why do you say that?
Like I said, as I said before.
But that's what happened in 2015.
2015, that was not the deal. 2015, the deal was Maithripala Sirisena was an independent candidate,
mm-hmm.
non-partisan, right? Podu apekshakaya. So we elected him to be without any political party, from an alliance, right? And then those who have a majority in parliament, he would appoint as prime minister. But very quickly, Maithripala Sirisena betrayed that pledge. He became the chairman and the leader of the Sri Lanka Freedom Party. I do not know why he did that. And then from that moment onwards, his pledge of being neutral, his pledge of change in the presidency, his pledge of having yahapalana, good governance, all that went out the window. Soon as he became leader of the Sri Lanka Freedom Party, it was survival for him. He was looking at a second term. How do I get re-elected? We did not elect Maithripala Sirisena for a second term. We wanted him to be a one-time president, right? Fix the country, create the good governance principles, right? Have proper law and order, hold those who have murdered and killed and robbed in the past accountable, right? And bring them to justice, bring them to book. None of those things happened. And after he became leader of the Sri Lanka Freedom Party, SLFP, obviously there would have been friction between them, the two leaders, mm-hmm. the Prime Minister and the President. And this went on for a few months, couple of years, and it came to a point where one is thinking of himself in terms of his survival, the other leader is thinking of himself and his survival. So obviously there would have been a friction between them, and it erupted in 2018 with Maithripala Sirisena as president calling on Mahinda Rajapaksa, right? The guy who he said, you know, by chance if I lost this election I would have been killed and 6 feet under, right? Swearing him in as prime minister. So there was something, I mean, the Yahapalana or the good governance dream, that vision was clearly over, unfortunately. So with it, the promise and our expectation of holding those accountable, creating a system where of fairness and justice, it just went out the window. And then each leader looked at survival at the elections. It's very, very unfortunate. The electoral system was changed at the Pradesh Sabha and the Nagar Sabha. Thing was changed. Another difference I can see in the Samagi Janabala Vege is here's a party, the leadership has pledged to 25% plus youth representation. No party has done that yet.
Mm-hmm.
We are the first party. Sajid Premadas is the first leader who has pledged 25% plus youth representation. What that means is that here's a movement where youth who wishes to go into politics, they have an opportunity to come into the mainstream politics, contest Pradesh Sabha, Nagar Sabhas, contest the urban councils, municipal councils, contest the Palat Sabha, provincial councils,
mm-hmm.
contest, and if they are successful and on their performance and their popularity, they can contest, they'll have a right to contest and a chance to contest for the next parliament elections. And once you're in parliament, the game changes. And if again, if you're capable and able and you have a vision and you want to do something for this country, who knows, someone from the Samagi Janabala Vege or the Samagi Tarunabala Vege in 10 years or 15 years or 20 years might be the president of this country. That will be something fantastic that we can look at. That is a fundamental difference. We are looking at youth employment,
mm-hmm.
youth empowerment, gender equality, and also giving the tools to our young people. We believe in the Samagi Janabala Vege. The most important factor, if you think of assets in this country, is our kids. The next generation, the young generation, the generation that's going to take over this country, is the most important factor, the most important sampata,
mm-hmm.
or the resource, the human resource factor, is the next generation. So we believe in the Samagi Janabala Vege, that this is our goal, that this is something that we have to do. We would ensure, don't forget, Sajid Premadas is not alone. There are coalition partners, there are other partners who have the virtue of the fact that the leadership of the Samagi Janabala Vege has agreed to this. So by the next election, not for the sake of giving nominations,
mm-hmm.
we would have a chance of an opportunity to select good candidates, young candidates. So like I said, they will have a chance in the mainstream of politics. They will have a chance in the mainstream of education. They will have a chance of in the mainstream of doing something for the country, making a change. So in the education, employment, we would ensure that our journey. This is also another difference between the UMP and us.
That is definitely a positive development, because like you said, the youth are the future of the country. Coming to the final question, I would like to ask you, what is your vision for Sri Lanka?
Well, I have many visions for Sri Lanka. I realize that we are a rural, agriculture-based country. We are economically really behind rest of the world. We always hide behind the fact that we are a developing country. We can develop our agriculture base. We can develop our technology base.
Mm-hmm.
We can develop our service base. We can develop our tourism sector. So it's a unique country. Sri Lanka is a unique country where I have not seen any other country like Sri Lanka anywhere else. It is sad that we had a terrorist war that has taken many of our promising leaders, including my father. But I see a lot of promise with the young leaders that are emerging. They have gone abroad, they have seen the world, they have traveled, they have read. So we are in a catch 2020 scenario right now. Which way this country will go will be determined by this election. Like I said, if we are truly blessed, the Pohottua party guys are no longer talking about a two-thirds majority. Just immediately after the presidential election, they were talking about a two-thirds majority. That is not the case anymore. They are saying, a marginal victory, a marginal majority is good enough for them.
Mm-hmm.
So things have changed. Things are changing. Things are very dynamic. However, I would like to see a country where kids will no longer look at shortcuts. Kids will no longer, and the youth of this country will not look at going overseas. They will say, hey, Sri Lanka is a pretty good place. We have opportunities here. We have equal opportunities here. On our efforts, we can prosper. We can grow businesses. We can be professionals. We can get into the government sector. There are opportunities for us. So the short answer is, I would like to see a Sri Lanka that will develop in our own pace, and a Sri Lanka where the youth of this country can say, this is home, this is our country. We have Sinhala, Tamil, Muslims, Berger, Malays, but all of us are Sri Lankans first. We are Sri Lankans first. So that's the country that I would love to see. That's the country that I'm fighting for. That's the country that I would like to see under Sajit Premadasa's leadership to develop.
Thank you so much for this conversation.
Thank you.
We have come to the end of this segment, but do stay tuned for the rapid fire segment.
I have a few. Nelson Mandela, John F. Kennedy, and Obama. Tendencies to say towards my father, but I would say someone like Jayawardena and my father, yes. Well, I try to listen to my father's speeches. I try to read whatever that's written about him. So again, my father. Favorite memory is we were swimming in the Kalaveva lake with the crocodiles, but again many, many years ago with my father. Best day of my life was possibly election in 2015. I'm a vegetarian, so I love fruits, so mangoes, papaya, so I'm vegetarian. So hobbies, love driving for a hobby, love diving as a hobby, used to do a little bit of sports as a hobby, not as a sports person. So whatever I can do to keep myself entertained. Also love a bit of reading, love a lot of movies. Well, I won't say that I want to be president in 10 years or prime minister in 10 years, or I don't see myself like that. But I want to make a difference in this country. That's why I'm here. If I feel that I can't make that difference, then obviously I'm wasting my time and wasting my life here. So the short answer is, I see myself making a difference in this country, and I see myself making a change, a positive change. I see myself being part of a movement to create a better Sri Lanka, a developed Sri Lanka. That's where I see myself. Oh, I love the hills. I would say the beach as well, but anywhere in Sri Lanka in the hills, love it. Best advice I've received is probably be patient, take your time, think things through, and don't go to sleep angry. Again, same advice that I was given. Take your time, be patient, read, study things that are going on in the world, adjust to change, and do things at your pace. And don't do something that is against your conscience and against your better judgment.
We have come to the end of today's conversation. I hope you enjoyed watching it. Thank you for watching. Take care and stay safe.